fighting. I crave blood.
Careful, I might.
Still alive, so that's progress.
Keep your distance, darling.
Together.
Watch your back.
Maggots will be done.
Thank you.
Whatever comes, I'm ready.
With pleasure.
Should mind my step.
We offer our pain to the Lady of Loss, that she may truly know her faithful.
Better not be cursed.
We offer ourselves to the darkness, that Blessed Shah may give us her mercy.
Bet that will fit in my pack.
May I inquire if, perchance, you retain among your traveling companions a man who adheres to the given name of Gale? Ever a man of leisure. And I would confirm it to be so. Please. After you. My thanks for your excellent guidance.
Elminster?
The very same, Gale. And a fair bit miffed he is, too, finding himself forced to...
I don't understand.
I was bid to spare nigh that time.
But why? Out with it!
Young man, has your sojourn away from Waterdeep washed away your decorum as nigh a 10 day? Why, some bread, cheese, and a cup of wine would...
Oh, for the love...
Fine. Plenty to digest, after all.
Elminster!
Right. Gale, my boy. I've come to address a most pressing matter. I'm here on behalf of Mistra. The message and the charge I bring you are hers.
Oh, Mistra's delicate feet are ill-suited for the hardships of the road.
You know where you went wrong, Gale. No, we needn't dwell on that here and now. But even so, you're to be given a chance of redemption.
Mistra would consider forgiveness.
She would consider what she considers to be forgiveness. Mistra is aware of the misadventures that have befallen you both. She knows of your strife with the Absolute, the very purpose of my presence. You must know that the Absolute is more dangerous than you can possibly conceive. That is why I have come here to charge you, Gale, with its destruction. It is Mistress' belief that only you can.
The Orb.
Precisely. Mistra has granted me the power to stop the clock, as it were, on the Orb's rush to overpower you. Instead, you will be able to unleash its lethal combustion at will.
Interesting. This could be help or hindrance. We shall have to see.
You must find the heart of the Absolute. Whatever that may be, and use yourself as the catalyst that will burn it from this world.
He is not. But it seems that Mistra is.
It brings me no pleasure saying this, my friend, but such is Mistra's will. Yours must be the sacrifice that will undo the Absolute. And for your sacrifice, you will be redeemed. Such is Mistress' promise. With that, I've said my sorry piece. And need only bestow unto thee the charm I was bid.
My Nahastra Mistra Aril. Ida Leon! Thras! Annas!
It is done. Both charge and charm have been committed into your care. To you, I commit into care Gale himself. I count on you to shepherd him well on this strangest of journeys.
Or some other fortune altogether.
Like moons make swell at, and yet a notion born in lonely hours. Calm ebb, calm flow. Even the waves of fate can break upon the shores of will. Farewell, my friend.
Farewell, Elminster. I'm glad she chose you.
Maybe it'll bring us closer.
An audience with Elminster is never less than memorable. I'd have hoped to introduce you to him in less dire circumstances. But the doddering act is merely an illusion, one he's most adept at maintaining. Elminster is the most formidable wizard in the realms. Perhaps in existence. For Mistra to have sent him, the severity of her bidding could not be clearer or weigh more heavily on me. Time seems so infinite when you're young. A month is an age. A year is a lifetime. It is a strange feeling. Of course. Then the slate will be clean. Wrongs will be righted. The absolute will be gone, and I along with it. If there was, I'm sure the goddess of magic and the greatest wizard who ever lived would have identified it. But alas, only one solution is offered. That remains ahead of us for now. The heart of the absolute must be discovered before I can stop its beating.
Something good here, I hope.
Something's wrong. I feel weak. Drained.
The shadows will not consume me. I am shielded by Lady I can feel the shadows' power here, but they don't seem to be harming me.
I just want a little look.
The shadow curse. It doesn't seem to affect me like it does others. Do you know what this means? I must be blessed. Lady Sha is protecting me where others are left to face her wrath. She loves me. She must do.
You're resourceful. You'll find a way.
Don't give me that look. It's a good thing that I'm resistant to the shadows. This way I can help. Lady Sha wouldn't bless me like this for no reason. Those signs we found about Dark Justicias, perhaps they were no coincidence. In either case, I need to watch for any place dedicated to Lady Sha. A temple, perhaps.
Stay together. Stop! Who's there? It'll be you unless you show yourself. Come out, slowly. Jonas, move in! Voice. Come back to the light!
Wanes. now.
With every breath, a purpose. I see a way.
Move unseen.
Ready for anything.
Quietly now.
Let's try this. Yes.
There is work to do.
Thank you.
going.
They're dying for me. All of them. To execute!
Well done. Now we've got to move. I know a safe place. Give me your map. Keep your torch high. If you step into the shadows, you'll be felled in a heartbeat. Remember, stay in the light or you're done for. Harpers, move out!
No one back home will ever believe this. I wonder if the gods are watching me. Don't mind if I do. Take that.
Last light in west, Moonrise Towers southwest.
The animals never have a chance. The curse consumes everything it touches.
Dead bird's been corrupted by the shadows. Would be wise to leave it alone.
stay idle.
Taste.
Next.
All right, what now? On my way.
This place is protected.
For a warm bed and
must be the
stomach,
refuge the Harpers
no
spoke
further.
Of.
Welcome to the Last Light Inn.
No shadows here. Something must be keeping it at bay.
You there! Step forward and keep your hands off your weapons.
Easy. He's with me.
Come, Jahira.
Hello. Kindness is too often a decoy. This is why we're here, you see. It is a curious creature that hides all manner of secrets. But if there's one thing that we know... it's that it knows its own kind. You should never have come here, true soul.
Protected the Emerald Grove.
Yep. Didn't leave a goblin standing. Not so bad to hang around with either. Saved two of my friends. One from a harpy, and one from a mad druid with a snake. Didn't make a fuss about thieving either. I pretty much trust him with my life.
A true soul with a mind of his own? How is that possible? What in the hells is that thing? Congratulations. You've earned yourself the benefit of the doubt. Hear me, Harpers. All clear. At ease. I'll not pretend to understand what that artifact is. But I'm old and wise enough to recognize a sliver of hope when it crawls out of the dark. Tell me, why have you come here? Then our interests align. We must all cure ourselves of the entire cult of the Absolute. There's food in the inn over there. Beds, too, if you require rest. Aloe oil in the cupboard, in case the vines gave you a rash. Settle in. Then come join me for a drink. You may just be the godsend we've been praying for.
More where that came from.
Wish we had stone or steel.
I wish we had a bloody army.
Please, I just want to be good. I managed to get away. I've always been good at running. I didn't realize one. I just wish I could have said goodbye. Can you?
Highness.
More where that came from.
Is that a good moment to talk?
Yeah, cursed to put my hands on everything.
That odd ox made it through the shadows.
Thank you.
trouble now.
You! A makeshift Harper's fire might not be where I hope to set up shop. And if you find any interesting materials in need of working, I'm happy to help. I hesitated to mention this back in the Druid's Grove, for obvious reasons. But when Elturel was dragged into Avernus, I was drafted into a devil's smithy. It should have been awful. Infernal metal. It's like a wild horse. I could sense some. Smell it almost. Somewhere in the area. Underground, maybe. Out there in the shadows. If you find it, bring it to me. I'll make something incredible.
Absolutely. Rare to get your hands on this stuff.
Need anything? Need anything?
Nothing hurts.
And blades always sharp.
Eager for battle.
Can't give up now.
Assume nothing.
Let's get going.
Keep a blade close.
haven't stopped me yet.
Need anything? I'll be here if you need anything else. Need anything?
Using something that's already fabricated is tough, but I can try. How many do you have? Mary. There.
Well, hello.
Time to rest. Don't waste the step.
It's for a good cause.
Stock up while you can. I only hope I've brought enough to see us through. If you're all right by Jahira, you're all right by me. Take care now. Blackets will be done.
What a day.
There were a lot on my mind. And
someone there.
Let's move. Let's go my way. What's up for discussion?
If you're all right by Jahira, you're all right by me. Take care.
And Mol put me in charge. What do you need? What does it look? Mol gave it to me and said I shouldn't let it go to just any old jackaday. I mean, maybe. But last light's best bargain. What can I get you? I'm alive, ain't I? What's not to like? Pleasure.
Close.
despite everything.
Don't touch me.
I'm ready.
Next, I wonder.
Maybe I need more pockets.
Don't be shy. Have a gander at the finest stock.
More activity among the cultists this month.
Please, to your very good health. Well, still not people. Answer me true and do not lie. Look around you. If we're to survive, I have no choice but to trust you. Can I? Good. I have every reason to be cautious. The cult of the Absolute is spreading through the city. We tracked them to this ancient village, only to be faced with a man we killed and buried over a century ago. Believe me, he was well and truly dead. I locked his corpse in the Thorn Mausoleum myself. He was a Sharan once. Took to building an army of Dark Justiciars beneath this very village. But he's returned. Not only does General Ketherick Thorn live again, it seems he is no longer mortal. He has become, in fact, invincible. We met him on the road here, commanding an army of the Absolute, intent on destroying Baldur's Gate. I put an arrow through his eye myself, only to watch him pluck it out like a splint. He healed, right in front of me, and chased us into the shadows. Things looked hopeless. But experience has taught me that no matter how bleak things look, there's always hope. You are that hope. Protected by your artifact, you can infiltrate his forces at Moonrise Towers, posing as a true soul. Find out what it is that makes him invincible, so we can strip him of his advantage.
Once Ketherick is without his shield, the sword, together, we assault his tower and put a final end to this blight.
Without a cure for your infection, your days are numbered too. I promise I will do everything I can to make sure you survive this. Any cure starts with understanding the disease. Whatever magic Ketherick's using to control these tadpoles, it must be at Moonrise. You're not our only secret weapon. Isobel, a faithful cleric of Siluna, and a light in the darkness. She cast the moon shield around the inn. It's the only reason we're still alive.
She's upstairs, in her chambers. Tell her I sent you, and she'll see you through the shadows safely.
Isobel.
Ah! You found your way. Good. I thought I'd scout ahead. Shades, death, harpers, flaming fist. There's a recipe I'm trying to replicate. That is, if you're still going to help Wulbryn and the others. In that case, you'll be very pleased to learn what I have in store for you. A new type of smoke powder. All the bang and boom of the original, but with an extra surprise. I call it the Brilliant Retort. You'll need it if you're going to survive this cursed place. You'll need it if you're going to get into Moonrise Towers. You'll need it. if you're going to save Wilbryn. Let's call a thing a thing. You, on the other hand, have... I'll do my part according to my talents. The brilliant retort will aid you. Thus, I will make it. Unless you've got access to a 300-year-old Tempusian apothecarial almanac? No. But that's for me to worry about. You do whatever it is you do. Some of us are counting on you. What now?
I'm sure you would.
There's...
Jahira said we should serve drink.
Jahira didn't save your ragged little tail from the cultists. I did.
Oh, it's you. I'd recognize that self-righteous tone anywhere. If you're here to save the day again, you're a little late this time.
Oh, sod off! I'm only here because you helped me and my family. I was ready to cut and run back at the Grove, but you had other ideas. Carl and Leo are taken in by your crap. You convinced them to play hero, and now they're gone. Dead for all I know. Or in the cult's tower with the others who were taken. They're my responsibility. You go save the world.
Thank you.
what's inside.
That might be worth a look.
Colors are faded, but the words are not. An ale between friends is worth 10 cups of tea.
She doesn't care if the Grand Duke lives or dies. I wouldn't go that far.